court here at Loras College. I'm Adam Rodriguez. Joining with me, Matt Haddad. Matt, how are we feeling today?
Feeling great. I'm looking forward to this basketball game. Looking forward to see what Loras can do. They had a game last night against University of Wisconsin Stout. They snuck away with a win. So hopefully they can do that here against University of Wisconsin Platteville.
Yeah, definitely a hard-fought win for the Duhawks last night. Like you said, hopefully they can come out with that momentum from last night and put on a performance here for us against UW Platteville.
Definitely.
Real quick, go over tonight's starters for the Duhawks. We got at guard number 5, Sierra Bachman. Down in the post would be number 11, Sammy Martin. Number 14, Sydney Schuler. Number 24, Madison Haslau. And number 35, Madison Fleckenstein. Now looking over at the Pioneers for UW Platteville, their starters are Addison Barrel, Lillian Guerra, Maya Domask, number 12, Allison Heckert, and number 25, Taylor Gilbert. I tell you what, I'm super excited for this game. Hopefully, Loras can keep up a nice little shooting performance they kind of had last night. About almost 35% from three-point line. I mean, that's an astonishing number from three. Tip is off. Pioneer start with the ball here. Barrel drive in.
Already got whistle a whistle. Already.
Not entirely sure. Maybe someone with the board, it looks like. She's looking over at the clock. Maybe it's numbers, time. Not entirely sure.
Whatever it is, we're resuming play.
Heckert.
Not how you want to start out the game.
Definitely not. Heckert inbound for Pioneers. Domask, 2 from Mitty. Just short. Haslau with the board. And right away, we're starting the jump ball. A little aggressive there. Haslau looked like she was kind of talking back. Pioneer play right there. Love to see the energy.
Aggression is key. You want to play with some physicality, but you don't want to get too physical and get yourself in foul trouble. That'll cost your team and yourself, too.
No doubt. Haslau down at the elbow. Bachman, 3. Her 3. No, not good. Rebound, Pioneers. Heckert down court. Kind of moving here. Duhawks, good transition defense. Heckert on the wing. Drive right side. Layup, no good. Haslau with the rebound. Martin down on a little break here for the Duhawks. She drives in. Dish, Fleckenstein, Flexen. Pass is intercepted.
Understand.
Good look there.
You want to get the open person, but sometimes you got to be selfish and just go up for yourself. Oh. I mean, that was a little too much passing there.
Yeah, just a little bit too much. Kind of was out of control, not really a lot. Didn't really slow it down. The idea was there. The pass just wasn't as strong as it could have. Three-pointer from Pioneers, no good. Schuler with the board. She'll bring it up for the Duhawks. See if the Duhawks will slow it down here a little bit as they have a little, maybe run a couple plays, get something going here to start. Fleckenstein, Bachman. Bachman at the top. Drive in. Nice little wrap around there. Schuler not knowing what to do with it. Drives corner. Martin down low. Good move. Good little move. Block there by Gilbert. Good block from the Pioneers.
Great block there by the Pioneers, like you said. But I think everybody on Loras' offense touched the ball there down by the on their side of the hoop. So great job passing. You just got to make sure you execute by the rim.
No doubt.
And that one's good.
Good bucket there from Guerra. Nice little jumper. Duhawks a little push there. Haslau at the top. Fleckenstein corner. Screen from Haslau. Fleckenstein all the way to the bucket. Her layup. Good take there. Nice hard take. Foul on number 25, Taylor Gilbert.
She's going to go to the line for her 2 shots.
Number 25. Nice thing. I think Fleckenstein's quick. Last night I was watching them against Wisconsin Stout, and Fleckenstein, she's quick enough to get to the bucket, and she's aggressive to where if she just goes up, she can take a hard foul and at some times finish pretty well and get that and one. Her first shot's good.
First shot, first points in the evening for Loras.
Second shot good. Back to Fleckenstein. Like I said, last night she finished with 18 in that 7-point win against Wisconsin Stout. I mean, she's averaging about 14.5 points per game after 2. Good hustle there, but not enough. Turnovers from Pioneers. Duhawks obtain the ball.
Broken up there by Allie Udelhofen. She got in front of it. Couldn't quite grab it, but she gets her team the ball back. Anytime you can get a breakup pass like that and get your team the ball and get some momentum, that's key because this is going to be a fast-moving game between these two teams.
Very true. Outside drives on the right side, drives in, good take there. Blocking foul on the Pioneers. That foul is on number four, Addy Barrel. Maddie has that now at the line for two. First one's good from Haslau. Second shot good. Ducks now at 5-2 here.
This season alone, they're 35-48.
Good hand there
free
from Bachman.
Throws.
Good steal. Huge steal from Bachman right there.
But a play like that doesn't make you want to worry about free throws.
No, not at all. That's going to be a big thing for the Pioneers this evening is limiting their turnovers. I was looking at their game yesterday versus Bethel, and they finished with 32 turnovers. Definitely not a stat that you want to see on the sheet at the end of a game. So I think for them that's going to be their biggest thing is limiting those turnovers and just playing smooth, getting the passes around, making strong passes, just getting to the rim.
Good thing you said that because Loris has 30 points off of turnovers this season. That's quite a few for just only playing two games.
Definitely. Travel violation from Bachman. Couple substitutions here for the Duhawks. Checking in, number three, Megan Murray. Number 50, Jamie Ryan. And number 11, Sammy Martin, coming back into the game. Not entirely sure what just happened there. She might have stepped over the line on the side. Couldn't really tell the call there, but
it's a lot of lines and rules in basketball that you don't quite understand what happens until you get a word from the official.
Yeah. Murray at the top. Swings it to Ryan. Martin cuts down. A little fake screen there. Martin in the post. The post hook. No good. Rebounded by the Pioneers. Hecker coming down to the Pioneers. She looks over, gives it to Barrel. Barrel dribbles up to the top, swings it. Get a little feed there. Nice little feed there. That's going to be a big thing for the Pioneers here is attacking down low. I mean, they've got a couple good bigs here on their team. Two of them last night finished with double-doubles, actually. Pretty impressive from both of them. Looking at that, it's that Maya Domas. And, drawn blank on the other one. But, yeah, biggest thing for Pioneers is to get those bigs going.
Of course. They got 24 points in the paint this season.
Yep.
Going to be crucial for Loris to stop them as
Bachman takes a nice hard foul there. She'll have two at the line.
Looks like Tessa Johnson's going to be checking in for the Duhawks here. Lillian Gary, along with Sarah Mueller, checking in for the Pioneers. Not a long drive from Platteville to Dubuque.
No, not
just
at all.
It's about a 20-minute drive.
Bachman's first shot, no good. Just a little short. Second shot, no good either. Rebound there from Domas. Here, bringing it up court for the Pioneers. Springs back out, slows down a little bit. Domas up to the top, right down to the middle. Skip pass, Hecker for three. Bang, good hit.
Hecker was wide open behind the arc,
wide
had
open.
Her hands up, and
yep.
She executed on that shot.
Huge shot there from Hecker.
Stoppage of play here. Let's see what it is. Maybe something with the clock.
I mean, they're having all sorts of clock problems right now. Goodness. Tess Johnson checking into the game for the Duhawks. Ryan down in the corner looks to feed Martin. Couldn't get it there. Skip past the Wittenbaugh. Ryan up top. Cuts down. Good little post feed there to Martin. Martin spin. Getting just rammed down low. Oh, good offense rebound there for Martin. Travel call on Martin. Didn't really see the travel there, but
that ball just landed right in Martin's hands. I myself couldn't see a travel, but would have been going up for two. And instead, it's Pioneer's ball now.
Lower Sears, little press on Platteville. Platteville just broke that press with these there. Garrett dribbling around trying to find some Hecker. Drive down baseline. Good D there from Murray. Feed down low to Mueller. Mueller, nice little post spin there. Good steal there from Jamie Ryan. Duhawks got a little break here. Feeds up to Martin, and it's stolen. Oh, never mind. And we stole right back. Martin. Another travel. Wow.
Another travel on Sammy Martin. Not sure what this is, but Haslow's going to check in.
You don't really see that from Sammy Martin that often. She's a little too good to have that many travel calls here and there, and it's kind of surprising to see two in a row from her.
She is a sophomore. She's just got plenty of time this season and two more to play for the Duhawks, but those are just some mental mistakes that you got to clean up to help your team out.
Definitely. Foul on the Duhawks. Not entirely sure who that last one was just called on. Gomez pass in for the Pioneers. He gets in barrel back out. Good hand there for Murray. Murray tries to throw it off the defender. Martin picks it up. Throw it down. Ryan for three. Bang. Good hit from Ryan there. Huge hit from Ryan.
Great effort there by Megan Murray. She just had her hands there. Almost out of bounds there, but on the baseline. Found Jamie Ryan for the three. And they find themselves up by two.
Yeah, definitely. That three doesn't happen if Murray doesn't show the hustle right here on this sideline, trying to save it. Good deed there from Haslow, just off her leg and out of bounds. Pioneers will keep it with an inbound down low. Couple substitutions here for the Duhawks. Checking back in is 35 Fleckenstein, number 30 Al Udelhoffen, and number 5 Sierra Bachman.
Al Udelhoffen checking in at 6 foot junior. She's been a huge asset to this team. She'll be a huge asset this year and a big one last year, too. I know last year was a COVID year, but any way you could get any help last year was huge.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, obviously, they put her in there for boards and a couple points here. I mean, she's averaging almost 5 boards a game, which is huge for the Duhawks to have that that bruiser down low to get you your boards. Not entirely sure what the call is down here.
Morris has got about 4 or 5 girls that are just 6 foot. I mean, you got to utilize them. Get some points in the paint. That'll be huge for you because, I mean, Jamie Ryan hit a great three but from behind the arc, but you can't always rely on that.
No doubt. I think as soon as they start, they're going to keep feeding Sammy Martin. They're going to let her do her thing, obviously. I think if you get her going early in the game, early first half, and you're going to have a lot of success if you're the Duhawks. Let's see what this call was here. Hecker thinned down the ball for the Pioneers here on down Duhawks. Good steal there from Haslow.
Great steal from her, just getting her hands in there. Beckman, she's got it now.
The top Murray from the wing. Duhawks moving it around. Good ball movement. Haslow from Chi-Town? No, sir. Off the Pioneers. Duhawk ball down low. Murray inbound for the Duhawks. Good cut there from Udelhoff. And one, baby.
Like I said, utilize her, and you get stuff
utilize
like that.
Utilize the bigs. I mean, it was just good play there to get her open down low by the bucket. Huge and one in the beginning here. Duhawks up 11-7 here in the middle of the first quarter. One shot for Udelhoff in here. Free throw good. Duhawks still in that press, putting the pressure on the Pioneers. Pioneers don't look too phased here. Good hand there for Murray. Good hand. Good hustle. Blocking coming down. Ooh, almost just fell over. Murray for three. No good. Udelhofen, good way to be aggressive down there from Udelhofen.
I think the Platteville coaches might have been looking for a travel there.
I could see it. I could see how they were looking for a travel there. Definitely. Mueller back deep. A little tip pass there from Bachman. Good hand. Fleckenstein, Murray, nice little trap at the top. That's the thing. I mean, if Duhawks are going to have some success with that little trap that they have in their press, I think they got to have that trap be a lot closer. That's the thing. UW Platteville's doing a really good job of finding those holes in the traps because the Duhawks aren't necessarily being so aggressive. I think that's what Duhawks need to focus on a little bit here in their press is be a little aggressive. Get the trap, make it a nice solid trap so we can really force a lot more turnovers.
Indeed. I mean, they're on a three-point run here. I mean, not too much, but, I mean, defensively, you just got to shut down Platteville in the paint. That'll really get you the ball offensively, and it'll get you good rebounds, too. I mean, definitely. You get points off of rebounds.
Definitely.
Udelhofen at the line. Her second time. She made her first free throw. Makes her second.
Off the board. The bank is open on weekends. Udelhofen second shot. Good. Substitution for the Duhawks. Martin coming back in for Udelhofen. Stewart in the backcourt with Mueller. Platteville just moving around. Unfortunate turnover there from Heckert. It just went right through her hands.
Got to bring it in. Those are crucial plays right there. You just don't think much of about it. It's just a routine pass, but those kind of things will trip you up. And it'll cost you in the long run.
Bachman up top getting stuff set up for the Duhawks here. Schuller in the wing. Drives baseline. Turn around back to Bachman. A little confusion there, a little flanking sign back to Bachman. Bachman up to the top, trying to get something going here, slow it down. Mark for the screen, Bachman takes it. The jump stop, Haslau from Chi-Town. Yes, sir, huge hit from Haslau. Duhawks up 10 here. A couple minutes left in the first quarter.
She's been on fire this game, whether it's shooting, passing, rebounding, steals, she's done it all. And it's only first quarter, too.
Yeah, I remember last year. Definitely probably one of the better shooters on this Duhawk team. Definitely want to guard her from outside the arc. Good little post move there. Ball can bring the ball up for the Duhawks. Comes down left side. Swings it to Haslau. Haslau up to Schuler. Schuler to Fleckenstein. Fleckenstein right wing. Drives middle. Nice little dish to Martin. Martin down low. Good little layup there for Martin. Excellent find from Fleckenstein, definitely. Mueller in the backcourt. Almost turnover there from the Pioneers. Good push. I mean, that's just too easy there for them. Way too easy for the Pioneers. I mean, what was it? 1, 2, 3 passes maybe? Layup. Schuler from Chi-Town? No, sir. Good follow. Good own rebound there from Schuler.
Looks like Loris is going to get a timeout.
Loris is going to call a quick little timeout here.
You like what you've seen so far? 2 minutes left in the first quarter?
Yeah, you know, I do like what I'm seeing here, but like I said, I think one big thing the Duhawks are really going to focus on is I know they're putting the pressure on with the press here on the Pioneers, but I think one big thing is if they're going to trap, that trap's got to have a lot of pressure. I mean, 32 turnovers from UW Platteville. I mean, there's no doubt in my mind that if they put a lot more pressure on this Pioneer team, they're going to bring up that they're going to have another 30 turnover game, and I think that'll really be a huge success for the Duhawks. And then just getting the bigs going, getting Sammy Martin down low, getting her touches, let her get cooking, and yeah, Duhawks will be just fine. Bachman down the ball for Duhawks. Up to Martin at the just at the top. Waiting ball outside the three. She drives over to Bachman. Bachman feeds it down low to Martin. Martin, good move. Ooh, turnaround fade, no good. Fleckenstein, huge offensive rebound from Fleckenstein. She takes it back out, slows things down. Schuler, Chi-Town. No, just right. Stewart bringing the ball up for the Pioneers over to Heckert. Heckert left wing. Drives baseline. Good defense there from Schuler. Oh, a little miscommunication on the defense side for the Duhawks. That's unfortunate.
Stewart from behind the arc hits that three from the bank.
You just got to wonder if there's a little communication error there from the Duhawks on who was supposed to switch or not. And she was wide open. Schuler up top. Down to Wittenbaugh in the corner. Steal there from the Pioneers. Good IQ play. Throw it off the leg, out of bounds.
Schuler was working from the baseline there and threw it back in, but Sammy Martin couldn't bring it in. Pioneers are going to take it from their sideline.
Maddie has checks back in for the Duhawks. Heckert and Stewart in the backcourt. Heckert to the cross half. Down low to Anger. Cool. Appears to be a hand check, maybe a push from Sammy Martin.
Martin came crashing in on Laura Anger, and, you know, you just can't do too much about that. You're going full speed. It's hard to stop yourself.
Yeah, hard to stop yourself for sure. Definitely had a couple of those fouls on me called back in my playing days.
Myself too.
Again, one of those would be just kind of full speed, just plow into them. Foul is called on number five, Sierra Bachman. Pioneers inbound it down low. Gomez, Heckert up to the top. Steal from Schuler. Schuler's got a fast break. Her layup. Good. Good steal there from Schuler. Way to be aggressive on that. As long as she was reading that pass from a mile away.
Tough thing about Schuler, she's a senior. She's only got this year left. Really going to miss her from opportunities like that. Working the baseline. She's a great asset to this team, and hopefully Coach Hines can utilize her as much as he can this year before she goes off.
Yep, definitely. And with the Duhawks, I mean, they only lost two seniors last year. I mean, both seniors they lost were pretty big losses for the Duhawks. I mean, you lose guard Lydia Bruning, who started quite a few games for the Duhawks last year. She was second in the team with assists. I mean, she only averaged two a game, but, I mean, she was just a big factor. She was the hustle player there for them as well. And also losing Ashley Funk, who gave you about 8 points a game and 4.5 rebounds per game. So, I mean, that's going to be a big loss there for them as well. Another steal from Schuler. Bachman down. Fast break. Slows it down. Schuler. Chi-Town. Yes, sir. Huge hit from Schuler.
They're just clicking from behind the arc.
Definitely. Only seen a couple misses for them.
Up by 10, that's huge with the first quarter winding down.
Huge. Well, UW-Platteville doesn't seem to be too fazed with the press from the Duhawks. You almost wonder if they either change up. Oh, half-court heave. Just short. You got to wonder if the Duhawks maybe, like I was saying, just maybe change up the press, maybe put a little more pressure. If they just back off because, I mean, Platteville seems to just be breaking this press just a little too easy.
I mean, you talk about bringing pressure. I mean, we've seen two fouls from Sammy Martin there just crashing. Mm-hmm. You got to be aggressive but diligent at the
but
same
not,
time.
Yeah,
you
definitely.
Can't be going hard all the time.
Of course. I mean, with the women's playing, I mean, there's three other Lorzak events going on today. Cup already finished. We'll take a look at the men's soccer playing in the national tournament up in Minnesota today. They played North Central. Squeaked out of a 2-1 victory over North Central to move them into the second round. A couple goals, or both goals actually scored from sophomore Reed McLovchik, one in the 7th minute and then the other one on a PK in the 12th minute. I mean, the men's team is on fire right now, and what a time to catch fire here for them.
What a team, too. My roommate Seth Krasinski is on that team, so congratulations to him.
Definitely.
And the rest of the men's soccer team as they stay at St. Olaf and they will play tomorrow.
Yep.
And a team, we're not too sure, but when we find out, we will let you know.
Definitely.
But also, Wrestling, they traveled to Decorah today to take on Luther. I know a couple great wrestlers on that team. Daniel Meeker, he got his name announced, and Jalen Schropp, too. Those two guys are two big wrestlers. Along, they had a couple great seniors and upperclassmen as well.
Well, that team in general, I mean, they're just a bunch of studs. I mean, ranked third nationally for wrestling. I mean, that's a good program they got going there, and I think they will most definitely have a ton of success this season.
For sure.
Back to this, I mean, Matt, 24-16 after the first quarter. Duhawks obviously playing well, a lot of energy from the start. What do you want to see more from here in the second quarter before they go into half?
I think keep shooting threes. That's been great for you. But try to utilize Sammy Martin. Try to utilize Ali Udelhofen down in the paint. I mean, you got great players like that can get into the paint and get a little dirty for you. You don't always have to rely on behind players shooting from behind the arc. But also, like you said, contest the shots. Contest down in the paint.
Yep.
Don't be so, soft down there.
Yep.
I understand you don't want to draw any fouls, but like we said, press, but be diligent.
Definitely. That's the thing. I mean, make it hard for the Pioneers for sure. I mean, the Pioneers last game against Bethel went to the line 37 times. But, I mean, it's a lot of free throws there combined for that team. But I think if the Duhawks can really limit the Pioneers' free throw line attempts, then I think we will definitely have a lot more success this game as well. Fleckenstein drive. She could have kept going. If she had a little hole there, she could have taken that to the rim, but draws a foul. Foul is called on number 5, Lily Guerra.
We talk about free throws for the Pioneers. They are 26 of 37 this season, 70%. So if Flores can keep them away from the line, they'll be doing themselves justice there.
No doubt. Bachman inbound the ball down low for the Duhawks. Has on the corner. Up to Schuler at the top. Over to Bachman on the right side. Bachman drives over to Haslau. Duhawks just moving around, get the ball. Everyone touching the ball here, finding a good shot. There's about 6 seconds left on the shot clock here. They got to do something. Bachman all the way. Good take from Bachman with the final seconds of the shot clock.
You want to get the most out of your players. You want to get the most out of the 24 seconds, but winding it down there always is a little scary because you work so hard to get it to the hoop. If you can't get it off, that's a missed opportunity.
Yeah, no doubt. Travel called on Nelson. Bachman to bring the ball up for the Duhawks here. Bachman up at the top, swings it over to Fleckenstein on the left side. Duhawks trying to get something down low to Martin. It's going to be big. Martin goes to work. Stolen from the Pioneers. Unfortunately, Pioneers have a little break here. A little 5-on-4. Martin back down. Swings it over to Guerra. Guerra, nope. Anger at the wing. Anger over to Nelson. Nelson's three. No good. Good board there for Martin. Oh. Domaskinless just stole it from her. Martin bringing it up the court here. Looking to take it all the way. She's about to go coast to coast. And one, baby. And one.
Can't ask for much there from Sammy Martin. Just capitalizes on that. Goes, like you said, coast to coast. Now she's at the line for an and one, trying to put them 29-16 up. 13-point differential is where the Duhawks sit at.
I mean, that coast to coast almost looked a little too easy for her there.
Yeah.
Barrel taking it down. A good take from Barrel. Angle there to get the rebound. Her layup, no good. Haslau down low, fighting for the board. Foul, good. Way to be aggressive there for Haslau. Way to be strong with that ball. Foul is called on number 24, Burnley Nelson from the Pioneers. Substitution. Check back into the game. Number 30, Ali Udahoffen, and number 44, Laura Anger for the Pioneers.
Seems like Sammy Martin and Ali Udahoffen are just kind of changing in and out. Those are their two players that they just really got to feed it to. I mean, Udahoffen sitting out behind the arc. But
yeah,
see if she can throw up a three or something.
Let her go to work down low. Haslau skip past Bachman. Bachman drive and a little chicken wrap. Schuler. Chi-Town? No good. Good board there from Anger. Way to be strong there. gear, bringing it up the court for the Pioneers. Looking to get something going for the Pioneers here. Nelson, left wing, up to Domas. Domas from the top, over to Guerra. Guard by 15-footer. No good.
That was just in and out of the hoop.
Unfortunately, you hate to see those. In and outs are the worst thing.
Unlucky shot there. Rim is not their friend on that one.
No, not at all. Hazo inbounding for the Duhawks. Bachman bringing it up from the backcourt. See if they can get Udelhoffen going here on the offensive side. Haslau from the elbow. 15 feet back to Bachman. Bachman up from the top. Drives right side. Over to Haslau. Haslau from Chi-Town. No good. Udelhoffen going to work down there for the old board.
Oh,
nice.
Smart play
there. Good little play there from Udelhoffen to throw it off anger.
Talk about aggression and playing with a lot of passion. That's what you do there. You try to do what's best for your team, whether that's throwing the ball off an opponent's leg and getting your team working again. Megan Murray, along with a few other Duhawks, Jamie Ryan, check in.
Murray to inbound, up to Martin at the elbow, over Wittenbaugh outside the arc. Murray left side, looks to feed it to Martin, cannot. Ryan swings it to Bachman. Bachman right wing to Murray. Shot clock winding down, 6 seconds left. Murray drives in right elbow, back to Martin. Martin drives, Duhawks got to get shot off. Bachman just hucks it up, no good. Good defense there from the Pioneers. Always a good effort from the defense when you can get that shot clock all the way down for the opposing team.
That's the second time I think that's happened to Loris in this quarter alone.
Yeah. Garrett Barrel and Domas in the backcourt. Domas brings it all the way up. Good defense there from Bachman. Swings it to Garrett. Garrett over to Heckert. Heckert drives right wing. Layup no good. But Anger's right there, just put it right back up.
Hecker was hanging out behind the arc there for about 3 to 4 seconds, throwing her hands up.
Finally got it and then took it.
Yep.
Wittenbaugh to Murray. Murray drives right side. Swings it to Bachman. Bachman brings back to that right side. Bachman over to Ryan. Ryan drives. Dish to Martin. Martin goes to work in the post. Wittenbaugh from Chi-Town. No good. Don't mess with the rebound. Garrett bringing it up for the Pioneers. Swings over to Barrel. Barrel on the left side. Back to Heckert. Heckert over to Domas. Barrel from three? No good. Good board there from Ryan.
You're doing a pretty good job pressing, like you said. That's what you want to see. But you don't want to foul because that'll get you in some deep trouble later on in the game.
Definitely.
When some of your key players are sitting with 3 to 4 fouls, or worse, they're sitting out of the game.
Yeah, definitely. Wittenbaugh up to the top, swings over to Murray. Travel on Megan Murray. I mean, that's 3 travel calls from the Duhawks alone in the first half. I mean, just a lot of easy mistakes that can definitely be fixed from the Duhawks here.
I mean, got to plant your feet. Understand you're trying to move fast, but yep. Make sure you dribble when you walk. Don't walk without dribbling.
Yeah. Domas cuts to the middle all the way. Blocking foul from Ryan. Domas going to go to the line for 2.
Looks like she took 2 Duhawks down there, Martin and Ryan.
Yeah.
Foul number 50.
Domas got the line for 2. Her first shot, good. Second shot, no good. Rebound by Martin. Martin to Murray. Murray bringing it up court. Good little hesitation all the way to the bucket. Layup, no good. Rebound by Heckert.
You got to finish on those plays. Great job bringing it down the court and great move, but you got to finish. None of that matters if you can't finish.
Definitely. Feed down low, no good. Stolen from Ryan. Ryan over to Fleckenstein. Fleckenstein wanted to pass it to Martin, but never did. Little dish to Martin. Martin going to work down low. Good hand there from Mueller. Martin, fade, no good.
You really want to see Martin. It'd be great to see her capitalize on those fadeaways. Mm-hmm. If you can't get a layup, those are the shots she's going to have to take.
Definitely. Heckert up at the top. Swings over to Domas. Domas looking to feed Mueller. I believe that was Nelson's, no good. Rebound for Martin. Martin going to look to push this all the way. Good spin. Short that shot. Timeout by the Pioneer. I mean, you definitely don't see that from Martin a lot. I think she was not expecting the contact when she got in there.
You just got to be prepared for the unexpected, too. I mean, you don't expect to get contact. You maybe want to draw a foul, but you just got to work with what the defense is giving you. And Loris, I mean, they seem to be doing a pretty good job. Up 10, 4:30 left in the second quarter.
Hopefully Martin can. I mean, she's got 5 points right now. It's not bad. Hopefully, you definitely want to see that number go up for a player with her, like, star caliber here on the Duhawks team. You definitely want to see that number go up throughout the game.
She's their leading scorer right now with,
I believe, 11 and a half points per game. Yep, leading the Duhawks with points per game. Gear up at the top for Pioneers. I think the Duhawks are in a little 2-1-2 zone, it kind of looks like. Trying to put pressure here.
It appears to be.
Good couple hands. Little tips there. Shot clock winding down. Wow, good finish there for Mueller. That was good possession from the Pioneers there. Stay composed, stay calm, and got a good bucket out of it. Good little dish there from Haslab. Just find that little opening, just dish it off to her.
Like you said, you want to be able to respond, and Loris responds perfectly there by dishing it out to their big players.
Beautiful.
And now
Murray fast break, layup. Good. I mean, just a little too much on the pass there to Mueller. Just kind of went over her head. Murray was there to steal it and get a nice little easy layup. Mueller to Guerra. Guerra bringing up the right side. Duhawks back in a 2-3 here. Nelson right corner, good trap there. Swings it over. Guerra, Chi-Town. Bang. Good hit there from Guerra. Murray bringing up for the Duhawks. So they can push it a little bit here. Fleckenstein thought about driving in, pulls it out. Haslau left side over to Ryan in the corner. Ryan crossover back left baseline. Back to Haslau. Haslau, Chi-Town. Yes, sir. Huge hit from Haslau there. I mean, get her going from three, and it's going to be a long day for Platteville.
But she's had numerous threes today. She's been hot from behind the arc.
No doubt. I mean, that's what, three already for her?
Wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah. Domestic little floater, no good. Ulihoff in there for the board. Ryan, look to push it up.
Loris
swings Murray to Haslau.
Total of 74 rebounds this season.
Good move there from Udelhoffen. Her going.
Wouldn't be surprised if half those rebounds are from Udelhoffen and Martin.
Yep.
You talk about getting the big players going, Udelhoffen and Martin.
Huge charge there.
The foul.
Woo! Love seeing people take charges. I mean, it's just such a hype and energetic play for the bench. Get the momentum back on your side.
And the fans too, you love to see it. If you can't beat them offensively, you got to find a way to beat them defensively, and you do it great right there.
No doubt. Quentin Botta inbound for the Duhawks here. Balkman back in the game, bringing it up. Brings it up Sully, get the Duhawks set up here in a play. Over Schuler, right wing. Screen there. Winton ball, right corner. Feeds it to Martin. Martin to Schuler. Schuler, Chi-Town? Yes, sir!
And Schuler's getting into the three-point action.
Big hit. Oh, yeah. Love to see it. When the threes are falling, it's going to be a great day. Guerra bringing it up for the Pioneers here, left side.
Coach Hines getting his team motivated, trying to get them concentrated in the game.
Yep. It's 2-3. It's causing it looks like causing a lot of problems there. Another charge for the Duhawks.
Defensive, baby.
Oh, man. Huge charge take there from Fleckenstein. I think this 2-3 Duhawks run right now definitely making the Pioneers a little rattled here.
We talked about that 2-1 they were in. Wasn't quite working. Switched to the 2-3. They've got two offensive fouls drawn on Platteville already. Back-to-back possessions.
Yep. No doubt.
Last one ended in a 3. We'll see if they can do that here with Haslow checking in the game.
Yeah, you definitely want the hot hand in the game. Lockham bringing up the core here at the top. Swings it over to Martin. Martin left wing. Putting swing back to the right side. Schuler at the top. Back to Haslow. Haslow Lockham in the corner. Brings up Haslow. Thought about shooting it. Good pump fake. Bachman up at the top trying to slow things down here. About 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Bachman drives. Nothing there. Haslow. Chi-town? Man.
Bang,
I mean,
baby.
She is feeling it right now. I mean, Duhok's up 20 right now. I mean, it's not even halftime yet.
I mean, what can you say? You got the hot hand in the game.
Yeah, let it run.
Two offensive fouls.
Yep, let the hot hand ride. Hecker from three, no good. A bit long. Gear offensive rebound. She pulls it back out for Pioneers. Barrel to Hecker. Hecker, nice little ball fake there. 15-footer, no good. Rebound by Haslow. Bachman bringing it up. Over to Haslow. Thought she was about to pull that there for a second. Over Schuler, Schuler, right wing.
I would try to use as much of the shot clock as you can. Wind the clock down.
Good take. Way to draw a foul there from Fleckenstein. Looks like a foul is called on number 12, Heckert there. Fleckenstein is now at the line for some free throws here. I believe it should be 1-1. Oh, never mind. She gets 2. Her first one's good. Second free throw, no good. Rebound by Anger.
Platteville's already got 5 team fouls. Not how you want to go into halftime. That's something you want to end the game with or maybe go into the fourth quarter with, not end halftime with.
Definitely. Good defense there from Fleckenstein. Martin up top, defending. Mueller, move. Bad pass, bad communication. Kind of got a little out of control there for a second. 5 seconds left in the second quarter. I'd be surprised they just go down and maybe pass up court for a quick shot here.
Haslow, she's inbounding it, but I would, if I was her, I would just rush down the court.
Yeah, seriously. Let Schuler throw it in. Kick it down to Haslow for a little 3 here and a half.
Exactly what I was thinking. Oh,
bad pass there on the inbound.
Platteville's ball.
Gary bringing it down. Quick jumper from 15 feet, no good. Lockman, half court heave. Oh, my goodness.
Looked like it was going to be good from here.
It was going to be good from here, definitely. Real quick, another Loris sporting event update. Just recently, 9th-ranked Loris College women's soccer made it their second round game today against Calvin, winning 3-0. I mean, this team, the women's soccer team has just been unstoppable all season. I mean, with undefeated record, 1 tie. They're hot as well. I mean, both soccer teams are hot. I believe that they can make a far push here in the national tournament for sure.
I would not be surprised. Both soccer teams are doing great. This women's team, undefeated, like you said, 1 tie against, I think, WashU, number 3 team in the nation.
Yep.
For G3.
Yeah.
And they previously played Fontbound, the team they played yesterday, beat them 2-0.
Yeah, Lord beat them 3-1 yesterday. 3-1? Fontbond definitely put up a better fight, only letting us win 1-0. But
yeah.
Women's team definitely look for them to make a push in the national tournament here, and hopefully, everyone hopes maybe win the national championship.
Bring it back to
Dubuque, baby. But after the first half, Matt, what do you think Duhawks did well? Like, what are you looking at as positives for them?
Well, positive. They're killing it from behind the arc. Haslow's got the hot hand. Schuler's getting in on the action.
Definitely.
They're a great job drawing the offensive fouls, too. I mean, that has been big for them. Got a couple points off of that. I mean, just try to be diligent. Try to be aggressive, but also kind of kind in the paint. You don't want to give them too many fouls or anything. You know, at most, you just want to – you know, communication is good. I think we saw a miscommunication down there with the inbounds.
Definitely.
But nothing hurt there as they're up by 21 at the half. I mean,
huge first half for them.
Huge first half. I mean, Platteville, they played against a Division I team, actually. Didn't quite do too well. But do you think with that experience and with the game last night, they have a little bit more preparation, but hasn't been showing here. But the Duhawks, expect a lot of them from them coming out.
Definitely, yep. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back for some more Loras College basketball action here. Welcome back to Loras College here for some more Duhawk basketball action. Duhawks starting the second half up 45-24. Pretty solid game here going for the Duhawks. We definitely have the hot hand riding from Madison Haslau, who's got four threes this evening, I believe. Martin takes up at the elbow, drives in, nothing there. Back to Bachman outside. Bachman slings it over to Fleckenstein. Fleckenstein left wing. Looking for something. Nothing's getting open for her. Fleckenstein tries to drive. Nothing there. Swings over to Schuler. Schuler to Bachman. Moving back around. 7 seconds left on the clock. Shot clock, excuse me. Bachman drives in. Haslau thought about the three. Nothing there. Good take there. Good strong take.
Great job by Fleckenstein being patient behind the arc. She could have shot it, but decided to wait for the open player and capitalize on it with Haslau. Looks like this might be Loris's ball. Turnover.
Bachman up top here for the Duhawks. Inbounds it. Pass it down to Martin at the elbow. Down low up to Schuler. Schuler, Chi-Town. No good. Good board there from Haslau. Fleckenstein left wing. Schuler, Chi-Town again. Nope. Gilbert for the rebound.
Great job there. Haslau giving Schuler a second chance. She knows what those are like. She's got the hot hand on the team.
Yep. Domas drives in. Jump stop by the elbow. Heckert in the corner. Thought about shooting it right there. Gilbert down low, Haslau defending, kicks out. Domask wide open. Three-pointer no good. Unfortunate. Unfortunate run out.
Would have been great there for Dozmo to get that shot off. She was wide open.
Schuler up to Bachman at the top here. Bachman swings over to Haslau. Duhawks moving around a little bit. Cross pass to Schuler. Over Fleckenstein left corner. Fleckenstein not going anywhere. Bachman back at the top. 7 seconds again left on the shot clock. Bachman drives in up there. Haslau thought about shooting it. Nope. Travel called on Haslau. Support travel there for the Duhawks.
And that's something, you know, when you take the shot clock down to its very last second, you run into a problem of traveling, fouling, throwing the ball out of bounds. Any of those things are possible. When you work so hard, you get the shot clock down to its last few seconds, and you make a mistake like that, that just really hurts.
Definitely. Unfortunate turnover. It's already two for the Pioneers here early in the third quarter.
Perhaps the miscommunication. Loris has got to capitalize on those. They're up by 23.
Yep. Pioneers up to 17 turnovers. Not even through three quarters yet. Definitely not a number you want to see on the stat sheet for the Pioneers. Haslau drives baseline down to Udelhoffen. Udelhoffen, and one!
There we go.
Big body down low.
That's what you like to see out of Udelhoffen, using her big, tall body. You know, give a little push and shove and throw it up behind the backboard. And
definitely. I mean, way to stay strong down low for Udelhoffen. Take the contact and finish through contact. Huge. Udelhoffen for one.
Just 17 turnovers this game for the Pioneers. That puts them at 45 turnovers the first two games already.
It's unfortunate.
Some way, somehow, they got to stop the bleeding.
Oh, Heckert. Gilbert is calling for the ball. Wide open in the short corner. Heckert drives to the elbow. Thinks out. Barrel thought about it. Nope. Not there. Mueller down low. Back to Guerra. Guerra up at the top. Crossover to Barrel. Ooh, almost traveled there. Almost missed pass there. Heckert left wing. Nothing there. 5 seconds left on the shot clock. Pioneers got to get a shot. Mueller, step back, no good. Guerra, good hustle. Oh, just out of bounds.
Oh, man.
Good hustle there from Guerra.
We're up top here. We can't really see that too well, but I wouldn't be surprised if they just get that off their foot.
I thought she maybe got lucky and saved it, but the ref saw otherwise. Murray bringing it up the court. Swings over to Ryan. Ryan to Martin in the corner. Blocking up top. Pass to Wittenbaugh. Wittenbaugh swings over to Murray on the right side. She drives, kicks to Martin. Martin goes to the post. Little move, little step through move. Love that little move there from Martin.
Great move by there, Martin. Murray was open down in the paint after she took the ball up. Could have capitalized there on that, but nonetheless, Martin patting the stats right there.
Foul on Jamie Ryan. I like the aggressiveness, but just a little too aggressive there for that steal. Great hustle there from her, though. Barrel bringing up back to Mueller. Oh, my goodness. Almost miscommunication. Couldn't hold on to the ball. Unfortunate there. Another turnover for the Pioneers. Ryan to Murray. Murray left wing over to Bachman in the corner. Brings up to the wing. Good defense there from Guerra. Martin cuts through to Wittenbaugh. Wittenbaugh down to right in the corner. Bachman cut through. Looked to be wide open down there. Unfortunately, couldn't get to her. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Pass deflected. And out of bounds. Almost a turnover there for Murray.
You almost wish Lara Anger just would have thrown that ball back, and now it's Duhok's ball, and
yep.
Not sure if she knew who last touched it, but
yeah, she definitely could have grabbed it and keep it in play for them. Checking into the game for the Duhok's number 33, Allie Bronson. Refs are discussing something. Not entirely sure what. I mean, if it's something with the board again. Goodness gracious. Looks like it is. I've never seen so many problems with the scoreboard.
I worked the live stream last year for the basketball games. Never this many problems.
Good take from Murray. Layup no good. Foul appears to be on Jamie Ryan.
Great rebound there by Denali Waldrop. She had two Duhawks crashing in on her. Just went up, put her head down, giving her team every opportunity they can get because they're going to need it going forward.
Duhawks back in their 1-2-2 press here. Apostolou back in for the Pioneers. Move there on the right wing. Heckert. Mueller drive baseline. Big force there. Layup no good. Rebound Martin. Martin's going to start the break for the Duhawks. Little chicken wrap. Fleckenstein over to Murray. Murray down to Bronson. Bronson. Chi-town. No good. Good hustler from Wittenbaugh. Foul calling Wittenbaugh. Love the hustle. Unfortunate foul call there, Hunter.
Coach Heinzen's got to be extremely proud of his team. Understand, you know, got a foul there, taking the shot clock down to its last seconds, but his team is just giving an amazing effort. Yep.
Heckert up to. Heckert left corner, right middle, nothing there. Over to Mueller. Mueller over to Waldera. Heckert in brown. believe that was Bronson they're calling the foul on. Yep. Just a little aggressive there for.
Diving effort there by Bronson. Love to see it. You know, we talked about pressing, effort, aggressiveness on defense. She's showing that right there.
Yep. Heckert inbounding it. Anger. Heckert corner, nothing there. Brings it back out. Heckert looks trapped. Pass. Travel from Heckert. Yep. Good call. Picked up that back pivot foot.
Bronson knew it right away. She was making the motion along with the ref.
Haslau coming back in for the Dewhawks. Couple substitutions for the Pioneers. Haslau to inbound the ball for the Dewhawks. Murray to bring it up.
It'll be interesting to see what kind of offensive, you know, 3-1-1-3-1.
Yep.
Or whatnot they go into here and going forward up as big as they are.
Definitely. Haslau on the right corner. Up to Martin at the top. Martin swings his flex sign. Martin goes for the screen. No screen. Murray brings back up to the top. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Martin screen. Murray drives in. Nothing there. Good take. Nope. Martin back for put back. That's good.
They must love taking that shot clock down in the very last seconds.
They really
seconds,
do. They really do.
I don't know about you, but every time they do that, I'm just worried they're not going to get a shot off in time.
No doubt. Domas drives. Murray Gardner. Layup no good. Good charge take from Martin. Bronson bringing the ball up to the Dewhawks. Coming in hot. Sosa down, kicks back out to Murray. Murray down low to Martin. Martin going to work. A step through fade. Oh, good hand there. Unfortunate turnover for Martin. Stewart bringing the ball up for the Pioneers. She's looking to get something going for him. Waldera right up at the top. Swings it over to Anger. But nothing's going there for the Pioneers. They're looking a little slow here on offense. Waldera in the corner. Travel call.
Loris, they've had their fair share of travel calls for Sammy Martin last half. I think Pioneers, they're catching whatever Loris had this half.
It must just be that side of the court.
Yeah.
Bachman bringing up the ball for the Dewhawks. See if Dewhawks can get something going here. Schuler right wing down to Haslau. Haslau, Chi-Town? Yes, sir!
Dang, baby.
I mean, he is on fire. Domas in the backcourt. Looking to good presser from the Dewhawks. No one there. Anger wanted it down low, but she didn't get it. Domas down to Anger. Anger going to work. Going to work. Layup no good. Rebound. Into a jump ball. Good hustle there from Bachman.
Bachman was not giving up on that play.
No, she was not.
It was like a magnet between her and the ball. Wherever the ball went, she was.
Yep. Bronson back in the game for Flagenstein. Pioneer inbound down low. 15-footer is no good. Forward from Udaloffen. Up to Bachman. Bachman with the push for the Dewhawks. Haslau wants on that left wing. Rightfully so. She drives in. Little dish to Udaloffen. Udaloffen going to work down low.
Utilizing those bigs, baby. That's what we love to
bigs.
See.
Ernie with Nelson. Domas. No bass. Over to the right side. Swings it to Nelson. Nelson up at the top, trying to get something going here. We got Stewart. Stewart driving over. Kick to the right side. Feed down low to Anger. Almost lost to Anger. Layup good. Good strong move there from Anger. Bachman bringing it up the court for the Dewhawks. Over to Bronson. Bronson drive. Layup no good. Bachman there for the putback. That's good though.
Helping each other out, helping your teammate out. That's exactly what it's about.
Yep, no doubt. I mean, just keep giving Haslau the ball. Serious. She is feeling it from deep. And then just keep feeding Udaloffen.
Yeah.
I mean, it looks like the Pioneers really don't. I mean, Anger's down there. Anger's a big body. She can be physical, but it doesn't. Udelhoffen just seems to be too much for her right now.
Mm-hmm. I mean, Udelhoffen 6'1", checking in. I mean, that's, I think that might be the tallest player on the two Hawks team. And you, when you're going up against another player who's, you know, 5'11", 5'12", it's going to be hard. That extra inch or two, I mean, especially with the shoes on, it makes a difference whether, you know, you don't see it or not. It really does.
Yeah, definitely. Mueller in the backcourt looking to bring it up. Duox still in that 1-2-2 press. Mueller ball fake. Bachman just a little too aggressive.
She might have kicked the ball there.
Kind of looked like it. Just a little too much body there. Pioneers now in the bonus. Checking in for the first time this evening, it's going to be number 15, Cassie Randall. Free throw from Mueller, no good. Second free throw, good. Bachman bringing it up again for the Duhawks. Randall left wing. Swings over to Bronson. Bronson drives to the middle. Martin left side. Martin's going to town here. Go to work, Martin.
There we go.
Nice little post move there from Sammy.
You think when Udelhoffen goes out, you get a break, but not. Sammy Martin comes in. Yeah. She fills in the spots.
Oh, yeah. Still from Hazel. Good hustle.
Oh. Valid an effort there by Madison Haswell.
Unfortunate. I thought she had it. I thought she was going to get away with that. Love the hustle out of Haswell. Referee discussion. Or
hopefully there's nothing with the scoreboard.
Oh, it looks like it is. Man. Down low to Mueller. Mueller at 15-foot. Down low to... nice little pass down low to Nelson. Nelson is wide open down on the block.
Great effort there. I mean, how much you can do at this point in the game if you're Platteville. You're just kind of playing for some pride right now.
Definitely. Down by Haslau. Chi-Town.
Bang!
Yes, sir!
Woo! That's what I'm talking about.
Looks like my boy Craig Collins out there when we go play pickup. On fire. I mean, 16 points for Haslau. I mean, when you got the hot hand, just keep letting that thing fly.
14 or 13 of those have got to be from behind the arc.
Seriously. Still in that 1-2-2 press here, up to the middle. Apostoli. Martin with the steal there.
Capitalizing on those low passes, making the most out of these turnovers is going to be big for them.
Thought Haslau was about to pull that one. Martin driving in, swings out to Bachman. Bachman left side. She drives in. Good take from Bachman. Good strong take from Bachman. She's got eight. Mueller in the backcourt, bringing it up for the Pioneers. Over to Pasalu. She tries to cut through two. She does successfully. Hand off that pass. Nelson right wing, guarded by Randall. Mueller down on that elbow. Good move. Good step through. Good hand there from Haslau.
There we go. Hot hand shooting. Hot hand defense.
Everything tonight. My goodness.
Breaking up passes. Breaking up shots. Creating her own shots.
Unreal. I mean, we're talking about how she's on fire from three, but I mean, she is currently shooting 5-7 from the three-point line at 71%. And that's just not really a number you really hear that much when you're talking about three-pointers.
Definitely not.
Mueller now at the line for the Pioneers.
You know, for as many as well as Platteville is shooting free throw wise coming into this game, I'm surprised they have not been in the line more than they have this game.
No doubt. I think that's just props to the Duhok defense. They're not really allowing themselves to get too aggressive and create fouls where the Pioneers can get to the line.
Great discipline, too, because you know, we've seen a couple fouls from them that were a little aggressive, but they've been able to hold off and keep those fouls to a minimum.
Unfortunate there. Randall could have gotten the shot off. Don't think she realized how much time was left on the clock there. Duhok's up 68-31 after the third quarter.
37-point differential, man.
Huge performances from Haslau and Nudelhoffen. I mean, they're and even Sammy Martin. Those three are getting work done for the Duhok's, all in double digits for points. And hopefully they just keep riding off those three. Again, a lot of Loris athletic activities today. The football team actually traveled to crosstown rivals, University of Dubuque. Unfortunately, the football team ended up losing 17-14 on a last-second field goal. I mean, I was at the game for a little bit. Football, I mean, they look good. They look really good, but, you know, they just couldn't prevail in the end. Unfortunate turnover at the last couple minutes. To let UD end up winning that game.
What a tough way for those seniors to end their season against their rival.
Definitely.
I mean, they played such a great game against such a strong UD team, and to lose like that, that's got to be a gut-wrenching loss.
Yeah, no doubt. Coming back out on the court. The five for the Duhawks right now is Haslau, Martin, Bachman, Fleckenstein, and Schuler. Hopefully they can just keep riding the hot hand.
We've been talking about how well Udelhofen, Martin have been doing, Haslau, but you got to give credit to Megan Murray.
Definitely.
And Schuler for finding the open players, bringing the ball down the court successfully.
Yep.
You got to think Pioneers are going to be trying to do some type of full court press right when you get to center court.
Yep.
And it's going to be on them to distribute the ball successfully.
Yep. I mean, we haven't said her name as much as you normally would, but, I mean, Martin's flirting with a little double-double here. She's got 11 and 7 rebounds. Haslau, Chi-Town. I mean, my goodness.
Oh, my goodness.
I mean, I'm at a loss for words for how, like, she's on fire. That's all I can say. Domas on right wing. Not really finding anything.
She's earned this Duhok win tonight.
Yeah, no doubt. Plug and sign to Bachman. Bachman bringing it up the court for the Duhawks. Trying to get something set up here for him. Down to Martin on the elbow at the top of the key. Haslau. Chi-Town?
Ooh.
No good there.
Just off the rim. Can't make every shot.
Nope, can't make everything.
But she's made majority of it.
Yeah. Domas. Good block there for Martin. Good defense from the Duhawks there. Heckert to inbound for the Pioneers.
Martin's been doing a good job not trying to get in too much foul trouble. You know, as much as they've been trying to push her around down there in the paint, she's been doing her due diligence of staying out of foul trouble.
Domas, good little post move. Unfortunately, just a little too much on that layup. Bachman bringing it back up. Dribbling over to the left side. Flankstein coming up to the top. Trying to get something going here for him. Bachman drives right down, right back, right baseline, and one. Not quite. Good rebound there from Garrett. Garrett pushing it up the floor for the Pioneers. Heckert drives in. Draws a foul.
Looks like Loris has got a whole new rotation coming in with Murray, Udelhofen.
Swapping all five. Whole new five coming in for the Duhawks with Murray, Ryan, Udelhofen, Wittenbaugh, and Bronson. First free throw good from Eckert. I'll tell you what, just as good as this game is, I tell you what, I am pumped for this for the Loris men's team after this. I mean, they got a good tester with Rockford. after last year only beating them by 7 after they were up a good chunk. I'm pretty sure, if I remember correctly, they were up by at least 15 and ended up only winning by 7. So they are in for what should be a very hard-fought game tonight.
Guys like Cole Navigado, Miles Berry, Rowan McGowan, those are the kind of guys that got to step up against Rockford.
Definitely.
They're the star players, and they got to show why they're the star players.
No doubt. Murray getting trapped. She turns it over. Good defense there from Pioneers real quick.
Getting a little edgy down there. Yeah. I mean, if you're Platteville, you're running, you're going back and forth, and having a hard time putting up points. But if you're Loris, you know, you don't want to get into, like, any type of technical foul trouble. That is the last thing you want to do, especially up as big as you are. Be smart.
No doubt.
Have fun, but be smart.
Yep, for sure. Duhawks looking really good, though. I mean, they're forcing a lot of turnovers, for sure. I mean, the Pioneers, like we said, that was a big thing that they needed to slow down. I mean, the Pioneers at 21 turnovers, but again, anything, like my coach has always told me, anything above, like, I don't know, maybe 10. If you have double-digit turnovers, I mean, you're just not going to, more than 15 turnovers, you're not going to have a lot of success. And it's shown tonight for sure with the Pioneers having 21.
I think you said it best. I mean, the turnovers reciprocates the scores.
Yep.
I mean, 33 points, 21 turnovers. You got almost more turnovers than you got points. I mean, that is just not a good look for the Pioneers.
Yeah, I mean, Duhawks with 36 points off turnovers. I mean, like I said, that's half, pretty much almost half of our points right now, of our 71 points have come off turnovers.
Props to the Duhawks and Coach Hines. I mean, he's really training them well.
Yep. Props to their defense. Garrett in the backcourt with Domas. Domas looking to bring it up. Up to Barrel. Barrel back to Domas. Domas over to Guerra. They broke that pretty easily. Guerra looking around. Good defense there from Murray. Scrappy defense there. Oh, almost lost that. Barrel. Domas. Domas at the top of key. She loses that. And again, turnover number 22. Just like we said. Ryan bringing it up. Thought she was about to pull that. Wittenbaugh drives in. Over to Ryan. Ryan dribbles down. Elbow. 15-footer good from Ryan.
Beautiful shot there by Ryan. The follow through the hand. It was great shot.
Very nice shot there. Over to Domas. Domas swings it up to Barrel in the middle. Ryan trying to come in from behind, get a steal. Lock and foul on Uehlhoffen.
Not surprised that was a travel there. Maybe taking one too many.
I thought
steps.
He was calling a travel, but oh well. Barrel at the line for two.
I mean, Platteville, you just want to capitalize on these free throws right here. I mean, does it look like, you know, you just want to make the most out of the opportunities you've got right now? Free throws, if that's it, execute.
Yep. You definitely want the points that are pretty much given to you. Both free throws good from Barrel. Murray bringing up the ball for the Duhawks here. Murray just dribbling around, doesn't know what to do with it. And like any kind of thing, she got bailed there with that foul. Foul on Guerra. She's kind of dribbling around, not really knowing what to do with the ball there.
Well, she's got the handles, too. I mean, if you don't know what to do with the ball, give it to Murray.
Yeah.
She'll find the open lane or the open guy.
Murray up top. Trying to get something going for the Duhawks. She drives down right side. Another foul on Guerra, I believe. Yep, foul call on number 5, Guerra.
That's 3 fouls for Guerra right there.
Unfortunate. Murray to inbound.
One more and she's in some foul trouble.
Brunson out to Uehlhoffen. Uehlhoffen 15-footer. Good.
There we go.
I mean, it seems like almost everything and anything is falling for the Duhawks right now.
I mean, everything's clicking for them. I mean, free throws.
No
three
doubt.
Pointers.
Yeah. Good offensive rebound there from Heckert. Brunson looked to be, he got knocked in the face a little bit, but foul on Wittenbaugh.
like you said, I mean, when the things are clicking and this game's so easy, when the shots are falling and everything's clicking, I mean, Duhawks are currently shooting almost above 50%, which is very good numbers, and Duhawks coming in now with a whole new lineup. A couple first appearances for them. Checking into the game is number 1, Tess Johnson. Number 12, Abby Welter. Number 34, Andy Perch. Number 15, Cassie Randall, who's checking in for the second time. And number 20, Hannah Thiel.
I mean, it's great when you see the reserve, second stringers, whatever you want to call it,
yep,
coming to the game. Notice you played well as a starter. Then notice you're setting a great example for the freshmen, for the sophomores,
yep,
for the juniors, that, you know, hey, if you play hard, you do your job, play your role successfully, you may not have to play the whole game.
Yeah.
You can have these players come in and give you a break.
No doubt. Perch down low, layup no good. Rebound, Domas, Garrett bringing it up the court. Up court pass, Hecker. Hecker drives right baseline, dish to, leave to be.
That was a great pass by Hecker there.
Oh, very nice pass from Hecker. Gilbert at the line for two here for the Pioneers. Gilbert's first three throw, no good. Second free throw, good. Anger checking back in for the Pioneers. Welter in the right wing. She drives middle. Nothing there. Swings over to Randall. Randall left wing. Back over to Johnson. Johnson. Chi-town? Oh, just short. Offensive rebound from Randall. Way to keep the ball alive for the Duhawks. Thiel. Chi-town? Nothing there. Perch.
For two on that one.
Oh, it looks like Thiel just maybe tripped over the volleyball line right there.
Anger checking in. I mean, she's 6'1", tallest player on the team. What do you think they're going to try to do with her checking in down so much?
I mean, at times you'd think you'd throw her in to maybe bully the opposing team's big, but, I mean, we have three girls that are able to, I mean, keep their own. I mean, Andy Perch, you look at her, she's also standing at 6'1". I mean, we're just we got three people at 6'1". I mean, it's kind of hard to contest. I mean, you think, all right, look, Udelhoff and Martin aren't going to play the rest of the game, but look, now you have to worry about another six-footer coming in at the center. So I think they're going to want to try to use anger as much, but at the same time, it's still going to be difficult for them to utilize anger.
So along with football, soccer, wrestling, sports happening today at Loras, the cross-country team, they traveled to Moline, Iowa today. The cross country Midwest Regional Division III, Moline, Illinois. And so Loras took fourth, and their total time was 1 hour 53 minutes, had 163 points. No surprise here with KC Rosenbaum coming in first. Average time for a mile was a 5:35. So great job by her and the Duhawks. I think their next stop is Louisville, Kentucky.
I believe so. I mean, like you said, no surprise with Rosenbaum finishing first. But such a stud on the cross-country team. I mean, multiple athletes of the week for the ARC and cross-country. And hard to beat her. Definitely hard to beat her. Anger, second free throw, good. Johnson bring the ball up for the Duhawks. Moves it, kicks over to Welter on the right side. Welter drives middle, nothing there. Cross to Randall. Randall to Johnson. Johnson up the field. Back to Welter.
Welter nothing there. Over to Randall. Randall looking where to go with it. She drives left. Middle to Welter. Welter's shot blocked. Perch there, though, for that rebound. Put back. Good.
Great job by Hanger coming off. I think she was maybe at the top of the key right there and slided right down.
Yep.
Blocked that shot.
Definitely good effort from Hanger, but even better effort from Perch. He was there for that offensive rebound and put it up.
Yes, indeed.
I believe the foul is called on number one, Tess Johnson.
I think Platteville might be bringing in some of their reserves, too. I mean, down by 40.
Free throw from Mueller, good. Yeah, I mean, definitely at some point, I think as a coach, you're going to want to say, you know, let's get some of these girls a get some minutes, you know, see what they can do.
Get them some experience because, I mean, they're the next wave. They're the next group of girls that are going to come up and lead this Pioneer team to a championship, a successful season.
Yep. Checking into the game for the Pioneers, number 14, Josie Nelson. Dunks bring the ball up, just a little handoff to Randall. Steal up at the top, swings over to Johnson. Johnson to Welter in the corner. Welter's driving middle over to Thiel. Randall thought about shooting it, wasn't there. Over to Perch. Perch pumps like 15-footer, just short. Almost like she got a little hit on the arm, but nothing was called there. Up to Anger. Anger, layup. Good. Good little push there from the Pioneers.
Great job there. You know, you just want to set a good example for your teammates. Yep. You know, just because, yeah, you're out of the game doesn't mean you stop giving a good effort.
Definitely. That's when, like you said it earlier, right? At this point, I think you just got to think UW Platteville is just almost just playing for that pride, just show that they don't give up.
Definitely.
Even when they're down. Welter up at the top. Keep personal foul on Anger. Duhawks bringing a couple more. Checking back in is Wittenbaugh, and making their first appearances today is Cassidy Marezik and number 32, Megan Stapleton. Up to Wittenbaugh. Wittenbaugh catches up at the elbow. See what she can do here. Stapleton on the wing. Wittenbaugh looking for something. Welter, right wing. She drives, crosses over to right side. Back to Wittenbaugh. Over to Thiel. Good pass. Oh. Good idea there from Thiel. Just Anger was able to get a hand on a good steal from her. Nelson on that right wing for the Pioneers. Good hand there from Stapleton. Love the aggressiveness out of her. Perch coming back in for Wittenbaugh. Footer, no good. Perch with the rebound. Foul is called on number 24, Nelson. Welter to inbound the ball. Lee Morozik bringing the ball up for the Duhawks here. Duhawks bring the ball up.
I was able to talk to Cassidy this weekend. They just said one thing, you know, two things actually, what they really want to focus on is
Perch. Chi-town! Woo!
From downtown,
it's
she connects.
From deep. I mean, if that just doesn't show you how well the Duhawks are shooting, then I don't know what does. Nice little Euro there. Perch rebound. Up to Welter. Welter slows it down. Back over to Morozik. She drives over to Perch. Perch, Chi-town again.
Ooh.
Ooh, just right. Good board there from Welter. Welter takes it in. Layup, nice. Good.
There we go.
Good layup. Way to be there for Welter. Love the offensive rebound. Timeout, Pioneers.
Like I said, I was talking to Cassidy this week, and she said, you know, a couple things I want to work on. win the ARC championship. That's huge. That's any team's goal. But also, too, with the COVID year last year, focus on communicating better. Focus on playing together more as a team. And that's really shown here. That's really been a good effort and a good, you know, example that they've been showing. And, you know, being able to do that is hard, but when you do it, you get great games like this.
Yeah, no doubt. I think this was definitely a team effort. I mean, it was a team win for sure. I mean, biggest standout obviously has to be Madison Haslow. I mean, shot the ball amazing. Finishing with 22 points. And, haven't seen that many threes hit by one person in a while.
I have not either. Maybe pick up basketball, but.
Seriously, steal from Stapleton. She's got the break. She takes herself over to Welter. Welter with the layup, good.
There you go. And it's even impressive to see this type of play from the reserves for Loris.
Yep. I mean, that just shows everyone on this team can play and everyone on this team will compete. Download Anger. Anger going to work on Perch. Her shot short. Perch with the rebound. Over to Morozek. She's going to take it. Perch. Chi-Town. Just long. Good aggressiveness from Welter there to get down low. Stapleton. And the effort is off the charts right now from the Duhawks.
I think one thing, too, with the game last night, a win tonight, can this Duhawk team play a strong 40-minute game?
Yeah.
They successfully do that?
Yep. Definitely. Apostle will bring up the ball for the Pioneers. Swings over to Waldera over to Van Order. Apostle drives baseline, nothing there. Nelson catches on the wing. She drives middle. Dunks out, floater, layup, good. Good move there from Nelson. I mean, it was good defense from Welter, but just better offense from Nelson. Rozek bringing it up. She swings it over to Stapleton. Stapleton to Thiel. Thiel to Welter, excuse me. Stapleton just short. The tip off the hands of Waldera. Duhawk basketball down low.
You love to see that bench interact. You know, they're at a point in the game, scored enough points where you can interact like that. I mean, great, you know, it's a great game to have the reserves playing. Because as you go further into the season, you don't know what you're going to run into.
No doubt. Welter with a good little post finish there. She's up six. Unfortunately, reverse looked good. Just good defense there from the Duhawks. Stapleton up the deal. Chi-Town?
My goodness.
I mean.
Oh, my goodness.
Wow. The three-point shot is on almost shooting 40% from the line. That's almost unheard of.
There must be a competition or something going on within this team for the amount of threes you can make.
Seriously, 40%. I mean, half the time you look at NBA, WNBA, and even the higher levels of college, I mean, 40% is an unreal number. You don't really hear that a lot, especially when it comes to three-pointers. You'll hear 40% regular field goals, but just three-pointers alone, that's a wild stat there.
And it's something to be proud of, too.
No doubt. Nelson over on the right wing, trying to get something going. Anger down low. Perch defending. Anger's layup no good, but she draws the foul.
Interesting to see. 12 seconds left. Can Loris get to 90 points? Yeah. That'll be a huge accomplishment early in the season.
No doubt. First free throw, no good. 12 seconds. Wouldn't be surprised if the Duhawks just get this ball and just wait out the last few seconds here.
I think that's exactly what they'll do.
Yep. No doubt. But, yeah, it looks like Duhawks probably just going to hold the ball here, slow it down. Duhawks ending the game after four quarters. Duhawks won, winning 89-43. I mean, just looking at it, three names stand out to me after this win.
Sammy Martin, Madison Haslau, and Ali Udelhoffen. All three kind of flirting with a little double-double with rebounds and points. But, I mean, huge team effort from the DuHawks, and you can't be mad about that at all.
I mean, if they're giving that kind of effort and putting up those kind of stats early in the season, I would just love to see, come March, what it looks like stat-wise for them.
No doubt. For the DuHawks, their next three games, the next one coming up, November 23rd, will be versus Simpson College. Then they will have another home game against on November 27th against University of Wisconsin-Whitewater. Then they will travel to Cedar Rapids to face Coe College on December 1st. As for UW-Platteville, November 17th, they are at Ripon. November 20th, they will head to Waverly and face one of our conference foes, Wartburg. And November 23rd, they will be at Chicago. Again, huge win for the DuHawks here, 89-43. Great team effort. Hopefully they can take that into next week. And stick around because, like I said, we got more DuHawk action with the great men's basketball game going on.
I'm
Adam Rodriguez on behalf of Matt Haddad. Thanks for tuning in. We'll catch you next time.